And we're talking about the House District 42 race with Republican Mike LaRosa, continuing our discussion. You know, this is the first election since Rick Scott, our governor, took office in 2011. His popularity has been low, historically low, in a couple of points. Do you think, in some regards, this could create a backlash on Republican candidates like yourselves, with voters saying, perhaps if they don't like him, that they suddenly don't like Republican candidates in other races? You worried about that?
I'm not. I've got a lot of hurdles and challenges in my race, obviously with the unique circumstances. So I've got to focus on the things that are going to get me elected, which are some of those hurdles. And you know, there's not a lot of time to dwell on that. You know, 30 days into a race, or when you have only 30 days to run a race, can't let all those things come into effect you.
Has Rick Scott been a good and effective governor for Florida?
He's getting better to the people. I've always believed in Rick Scott and his long-term plan, and I think, you know, there's an opportunity, that there's a reason they're there for 4 years, and those things start to ultimately play out, and there's some positive that's coming, and I think by the time the end of his term, we'll realize that he's done some good for our community.
You did mention that incentives. You're not in favor of some of the incentives, and in fact, there were a series of newspaper articles, investigative reports that were done during the past year that looked at the incentives that really hadn't been recouped, the millions of dollars that have been invested in businesses and really not come back. Do you disagree with some of those?
You know, we cannot waste in this critical time. We're obviously, our economy is very fragile. My district, you know, you see it driving down, you know, the streets of 192 or down into Polk County. We have to be very careful how we give out incentives. It can no longer be a blank check to companies come in and promise the world. We have to make sure that they're performance-based. I've never written a contract in my business that doesn't have a performance trigger on there. I don't hand a check before there's any accountability.
Is there a difference between, let's say, a tax credit which rewards a job creation? Do you support that, or is there a different way to incentivize businesses to come to Florida and create jobs?
I think we have to look at all different angles. You know, there's many companies, types of companies coming here, big and small, and depending on the structure of the company and what they're going to do and what their long-term plans or maybe what their short-term plans or maybe even what industry that they're in, I think those all need to be considered. So it's maybe not a one-size-fit-all. It's maybe a structure that's allowed for certain small businesses, maybe medium-sized businesses, and maybe large businesses, depending on what their overall impact is going to be to our community.
If you want to help create jobs in Florida, if you are elected, if you go to Tallahassee, what one specific thing would you do to help to create jobs, other than telling everybody to buy houses from LaRosa Realty?
No, absolutely. Well, once those jobs are created, then that will just naturally happen. Of course, you know, we'll start to spur our economy. But we have to be efficient. We have to be efficient. And in these times, I could not run my business with any loose dollars going in directions that they weren't very effective. So we've got to take that message to Tallahassee. I've got to show Tallahassee that what I've done in the private sector, I can ultimately use and teach and be adopted by the public sector.
All right. We're going to finish up. I noticed this week Eileen Game, the Democrat in this race, she's received the endorsement of the Osceola County Professional Firefighters and Florida Professional Firefighters. Are you seeing in the last week, since your name surfaced in this race, any support from groups who are coming to you?
Yes, we are. And of course, we're trying to spread myself as thin as possible to get out there to get the message out. And we are talking to many different organizations. And we feel very confident that we're going to have some endorsements here coming very soon. I know that she's received a few, but by no means are we worried about organizations that she's, I think they're historically maybe would lean on her side to begin with.
All right. Mike LaRosa, Republican in the House District 42 race. Again, this is the replacement candidate for Mike Horner, who dropped out of the race. He's facing Democrat Eileen Game, who declined to be on our program today because of a scheduling conflict. Thanks a lot for talking
with
us.